Hi folks, welcome back. I hope you're all doing well. So I wanted to continue learning about prompt engineering, and today I want to look at a paper that takes a look at how you might actually use large language models themselves to generate good prompts. Getting large language models to perform well on a task basically boils down to eliciting the right output from it by giving it an appropriate prompt. That's why prompt engineering is so important. And typically the way people have dealt with it is just by human trial and error. They just try a lot of prompts until they get one that gives them the output that they're looking for. And that is the problem that the authors in this paper are trying to solve. They're asking, well, what if we could automate some of that? And the way they do that is really interesting because they've turned it around to use the large language model itself to help us generate better prompts for a task. So how do they do that exactly? They use the language model, first of all, to generate possible candidates. And they do that by giving it a few input-output pairs as examples. And that gives you a prompt to start with. They generate variations of that prompt, again using a large language model, and then they try to score all those variations. And that gives them a top candidate with the top score. This diagram explains the entire process. They feed in a bunch of demonstrations to the large language model. This gives them some candidates for prompts. Those candidates are then scored, and they also generate variations of those prompts and keep scoring them, and finally they find the best prompt. I'm going to switch over to this tweet thread by Kieran Pastor, who is one of the authors of this paper, because he has some really interesting animations that explain this concept pretty well. This is an example of a prompt template with input and output examples that you can feed to a language model in order to get a candidate prompt. So this is what is called a forward generation template because the fill in the blank comes at the end. You could also frame it slightly differently, and that's called a reverse generation template. And then you also use the LLM to generate variations of that prompt. And then you use all these variations on your benchmark to score how well they did. They're essentially treating prompt engineering as a black box optimization problem. And the cool part is that they use language models themselves to generate the candidate prompts, to evaluate them, and to iteratively propose new ones. And you can see in this graph that on a large number of tasks, on the majority of tasks, in fact, this automated prompt engineering strategy comes close to or beats prompts that have been crafted by humans. The greedy strategy here is from some prior work. Just to give you a concrete idea of what these tasks are like, they are actually fairly simple, things like finding the first or second letter of a word, or finding out the plural of a word, or converting from active voice to passive voice, and so on. A lot of language-related tasks like antonyms or synonyms. They also have some interesting arithmetic tasks like finding out the sum or difference of numbers. And then finally, they have some sentiment analysis or analysis of similarity. So that was a quick look at some really interesting work, which tries to ease some of the challenges of coming up with good prompts to solve a task with large language models. Now, the tasks they're looking at are fairly straightforward, and I wonder how this work will extend to the more creative tasks that we see a lot of people trying to do with large language models like GPT-3, things like completing short stories or poems or style transfer and so on. But very interesting work nonetheless. I hope you enjoyed that, and I will see you next time. Thank you very much.